Hey, and what is happening, guys? Yankee here. We're back for some more Let's Play Banjo-Tooie. In the last part, we began this weird and strange world, and in this part, we'll be continuing this weird and strange world as Kazooie first, because we'll be splitting up for the majority of the video, because we'll have to be unlocking many things, and that involves Kazooie and Banjo going their separate ways. And we have to avoid these gingerbread men wielding various objects of obscurity. Still don't know why, but we don't want to question it. But anyway, we'll begin by first, okay, Kazooie, don't hatch the ground, hatch the egg. We'll continue first by unhatching these two eggs right here. Like we saw by the Warpen Central Cavern, this helped unhatch a floaty thing that Banjo could put in his backpack and get across to various areas. So that'll make Banjo's life a lot easier because he has a lot of G's, like I said before, in this world, and that is definitely going to help his cause. And we just have to go over here with the suction cup boots now and unhatch another egg, and yeah, we'll be pretty much unlocking the first step of Banjo's things. And okay, I really don't know why the suction cup boots are even over here. You can't go down with them, so it always puzzles me why they are there. Like, I don't know, does anyone know? Like, I've mentioned this like on a number of occasions, but I really just don't know. And yeah, so we unhatched that egg, but right now we're gonna actually go over here because we're gonna use this plant right here to take us to the trash can that we saw in the sky that we got the empty honeycomb off of on the top by flying it in the first part. And we'll be going inside actually as Kazooie because she can only enter here. And let's see, inside the trash can. Oh, we got a ginger over here. Or is it? It's an enemy! Oh, what? I missed. Okay, let's try it again. And the ginger would even bat an eye, the Minjo, sorry. But yeah, there we go. Third time's the charm to kill something. That's what they always say, right? But anyway, let's talk to this guy. Basically, he's like, oh yeah, we have a lot of germs in here. But my thing is, like, don't you want a lot of germs to be in your trash can? That's kind of what a trash can is. But yeah, this guy's basically facing eviction from the health department. And we gotta help him out. We gotta kill some germs. And it's basically another one of those mini-games where blue is worth 3, green is worth 2, and red is worth 1. A little repetitive on this game, and it's already the last world, so I'm not gonna complain. So yeah, let's just go on ahead and take him out. But yeah, since we're on the subject of germs, one of the reasons why I took a little break right there between videos because I actually got the stomach flu. Yeah, I never get sick, and it's the first time I actually had the flu, so it was a very interesting experience. Not one I want to have again. I really don't know how I even got sick. I think it was just more of like everyone was getting it. I think one of my cousins actually had it during Christmas. And I actually looked it up, and the flu actually like incubates in your body for a couple of days, then it like reacts. So maybe that was the cause. I thought I was food poisoning initially. I had bad Chinese food, I thought, but no, it was just stomach flu. And yeah, it was just a very painful and experience I really don't want to have again. So yeah, I didn't get a flu shot, so it's probably bad on me. But yeah, we got 82 points, and I hate shots. I hate needles. Yeah, basically, he gets to keep his trash can. We got 32 more points than we needed. No extra bonus. But yeah, we got the Jiggy, so that's all that matters, right? And I hate when they always ask, do you want to play the minigame again? No, we do not. Why would you want to? And yeah, tell your friends to come and visit. Yeah, I'm going to tell my friends to come with me to visit a trash can. I don't think they would hang out with me anymore. But yeah, basically, what you want to do is go on this Coca-Cola bottle and just fly over here onto like a little edge spot because we have to actually shoot something over to get a Jinjo. And it kind of takes a little maneuvering and I keep falling off, that doesn't help. And I'm falling off this salty snack treat box with extra salt. Yeah, you can actually use a clockwork egg. And there you go, clockwork eggs are amazing. And there we go, the red Jinjo family is complete. So there's another Jiggy right there. We're getting a lot of Jiggies toward the end because there's 90 in the game, we have 75 and snatty fanny chonks. Jolly's Juice. Okay, this is Jolly Roger's, I guess, juice supply, and Jolly's, just the name Jolly's Juice, that doesn't sound right, but yeah, we have a little milk carton right here, but what's on the side? Missing. Tootie, last seen in Banjo-Kazooie, so you mean to tell me that Banjo's sister has been missing since the last game and he hasn't raised that up? Like, really, guy? Like, dude, Amber Alert that shit. Like, your sister's missing, but no, no, no. We gotta revive our dead friend, but heck, our dead sister might be out there. Who cares about her, right? But yeah, I'm using the clockwork egg in the back of the trash can, basically. activate one of the numbers with the super stash. So there we go. Two more to go. So one blank blank four. One, two, three, four. It's the same number of my luggage. Okay. I had to make that. I think it was one, two, three, four, five. But close enough. But anyway, what we want to do is actually fly over here. Because there's one more thing that we can actually do with Kazooie. I might as well tackle it now. And that is compete in the first event against Mr. Fit. And that is the long jump. I don't know why I couldn't say the right name of the track event in the first part. I really got a freaking brain fart there. But look at Kazooie. I just love the animation when she's flying with the spring jump boots. It's like she's having a seizure. I might zoom in on that. But yeah, basically just jump over the high jump bar and there we go. We got it. And we stuck the landing. How'd you do that? Well, yeah, we kind of cheated there, but you were too, I guess, in the zone to notice, but yeah, we'll be using a lot of different ways to beat this guy. I actually feel kind of bad, but, you know what, no one's watching, so might as well do whatever we can to get these jiggies. We have a good cause for cheating, so it's not like we're just doing it for the records, like some, players in some sports who use steroids. Not gonna name any names. A-Rod, okay, But anyway, yeah, a little topical. Let's actually glide on over to Banjo because Kazooie's turn in unlocking all the things is over. And she actually got to do one of the fit events, so that's nice. And now we'll be switching over to Banjo because he'll actually be doing one of the half points of what we have to do here because we don't need Mumbo just yet. We actually have to do something with Banjo first. And that is actually just going up here. And you know those two beans that we actually collected? We'll be actually using them, we'll be planting them, and then Mumbo will have some use. So let's actually go over here first and get a Jiggy. I like the little thing right here, hold on. Bouncy castle! Yeah, we're bouncing on a gelatin castle. Yeah, who wouldn't have, like, as a kid, this was like my dream. Having either a Jello castle or having a pool filled with Jello. Having a slide going from my room to the pool, well that's another thing, but yeah, come on, what kid wouldn't have wanted that? So yeah, we got that Jiggy right there. We're gonna make our way back up and plant those two beans like I was talking about because they actually involve Mumbo in a way. And yeah, if we do it now, we actually save some time because you can actually use Mumbo now, but it'll only unlock one of the three things he can do. So we might as well get all three things done then use them because then that's saving time, you know. Gotta cut corners here and there. Okay, this part is very dangerous. You want to pay very much attention to that bee right there because if he hits you, you're going to fall off the side. And that happened many, many times in my practice run and happened in my failed recording of this. Oh, to save myself embarrassment, I actually did it. Yeah, all right. You'll never know of my failure. I lost the footage. Or did I? Or maybe I just edited it out. But anyway, no. That was in the last failed recording. This time I did it in one shot, so we're gonna use that floaty thing in our backpack, and Banjo's very, like, reliant on this backpack for a lot of things. Like, I'm just imagining, like, the straps would just break right there and he just falls to his doom, but he's like, oh, I'm immortal. That's his words, really. I'm immortal. I can see, like, Goofy saying that, too. Because, yeah, death has no consequence in this game, so he planted the bean. And now we're gonna make our way to the red Mumbo side and plant the other bean, because that's where we can plant it. And then we can enlist Mumbo's help, so, yeah, Central Cavern is basically the central hub area of the world. And I forgot to mention, but there's only two warps in this world, which is very interesting. Basically, there's only one by the entrance and there's one in here, so it's kind of a small world, but it's not. It actually, it's one of the easiest worlds in the game, actually, when you come down to think about it, because once you know where everything is and where everything, like, centers around, every door goes to, you can actually beat this world relatively fast. Like, I think I could definitely beat this world much faster than Grunty Industries, that's for sure. Had much easier time, and even Hailfire Peaks you could do in a longer time. You could do a short time in Click... Okay, it's not Click Clock Wood, it's Cloud Cuckoo Land. I said that in the last part, I apologize. But bottom line is, Cloud Cuckoo Land is actually a pretty easy world when you get down to it. And now that we're done with that tangent, let's float on over there and plant the second bean, and then we'll be done with Banjo. So there you go, they actually give you enough time to get over so you don't have to freak out and like worry you're gonna fall to your doom eventually when that thing just bails on you. Cause you think that thing would have more of a heart, it has a 10 second time, it's like, okay, I'm done within your backpack, peace. But yeah, do I actually, can I do the Sack Race now? No, I can't. Mumbo's help, duh. Because that will let me get up to the point where I can do that, so... Don't want to jump the gun just yet, and... I love when you do, like, the double jump in midair while you're falling to your doom. It's, like, weird jump anim- I don't know, it was a little weird falling animation right there that we saw. Like, he stopped in midair, then fell. And, okay, these... I just hate these enemies. They really just come up every... Stop! Okay, you know what? Banjo, I'm sorry to do this, but we're just gonna kill you because it'll take too much time getting back up there, and... Death by flower to the head. Alright, so anyway, now that we have Kazooie reunited, let's actually get the third Super Stash safe number before we actually go to Mumbo. Yeah, I'm building up Mumbo a lot, but we actually gotta do a bit more things to get to him before we get to him. So yeah, let's actually go over here because what we need to do is have a clockwork egg. And we got plenty of those, so yeah, the clockwork egg is by far the most useful egg in the game, can get to any area relatively easily, and it's pretty necessary to get a lot of the GGs in this game, that's for sure. And so yeah, we basically have to grip grab over here, watch this thing, pretty invisible right there, we gotta zoom out all the way and you'll be fine. And they give you plenty of eggs over here in case you don't have a clockwork egg, so you should be good on ammo. And there we go, let's shoot one down, and basically have to go all the way to the other side, and we'll have the third number of the Super Stash out of four. I don't know, we'll probably be having the Super Stash fully opened in the next part, because next part will be pretty much, I don't know, I think in the next part we'll be finishing up this world, all the things, because we're making great time right now, and this world, like I said before, is really not that long. It's one of the shorter worlds in the game compared to most of them, and yeah, it's actually pretty convenient that I know this world pretty well because I practiced so many times during the break, and yeah, I guess practice does make perfect. But anyway, now we're gonna get Mumbo in the blue hut. He is the good Mumbo. It's like, it's pretty much like Star Wars, blue is good, red is bad, and basically what's... Hey, Jinjo, how's it going? Oh, okay. And there we go, that's another Minjo bites the dust. And basically, there was a good Jinjo in the bad Mumbo's hut, and there is a bad Jinjo in the good Mumbo's hut. And I just love this little conversation right here between Mumbo and Banjo. Like, I love how Banjo doesn't tell Mumbo there was a freaking, like, Terminator doppelganger of him in this world. Like, wouldn't you tell your friend maybe that there's, like, an alternate version of themselves? Especially a freaking killing robot? Like, Banjo, you're the worst friend ever. But I don't know, maybe he's the best friend ever not telling Mumbo in the first place. Like, you don't want to know that. You don't want to know if there's an evil version of yourself out there. But yeah, with terrible friendship aside, let's move on with Mumbo and do his easiest, I think, spell in the game. It's his last one too, so it's gonna be pretty bittersweet seeing that. And we actually make our way over by the suction cup area that we use Kazooie. Yeah, we just gotta go past that and go up this ledge right here, and they actually make it very accessible for Banjo. And, not Banjo, Mumbo, sorry, I caught myself there. I always confuse names and things, and I always never catch it, and just like with the click clock would in the last outro, but, yeah, we just gotta walk over here with Mumbo, not fall, and, ooh, there's notes over here, cool. I think we almost have all the notes in this world. And, basically, this is the final, the fit events, this is number three, I believe, it's a nice little racetrack. So you can get an idea who'll be using for that event, but basically, yes, another Zuba trap, another B trap. You gotta watch this guy, because if he hits you, you can go off the edge very easily if you're gonna walk up to that Mumbo pad, so you gotta take it nice and slow, and there we go, okay. Yeah, I don't know, they're very evil over here, putting those things right there for you to fall off, but you know what? Rain dance. Alright, so Mumbo did work right there. Not only did he make a rainbow, and okay, Mumbo, sorry about that, but you're gonna fall to your demise. We used you up throughout the whole entire game, and there you go. A warrior's death. But anyway, not only do we make a rainbow, and I'm not gonna kill that black ginger, that'd be a hate crime. Okay, but anyway, why did I make that joke? That was such a dumb joke. But anyway, not only did that make a rainbow, it made two beanstalks that we pretty much got uprooted because we planted those beans before. If you didn't do that, then they obviously wouldn't grow. And it's kind of like ingenious that they did that, because like you wouldn't really think like, oh, you have to do something before you actually use the mumbo pad. And it's cool that it actually follows, like if you plant the beans and it grows up with the water, that's pretty smart. I don't know. But over here is actually where we can get across the rainbow into the pot of gold, which will probably be the last thing we'll be doing in this part. And we actually have a time limit right here to get across. We only got 20 seconds, but we should make it over there pretty fast. And if you didn't have the rainbow, it's actually impossible to get over there because you don't have a fly pad right by there. And it's pretty much impossible to get over here in the 20 seconds required. So you'll need the rainbow with Mumbo's help. And yet another Minjo. Like, they're really just going out for blood here. I feel kind of bad. We're like killing all the Minjos over here. But yeah, I guess with Bob Parker spaying into your Minjo and we're controlling the Minjo population. But yeah, we got some fire egg right there. That one is the normal egg, and pretty much just match up which one looks cool, which one is which is pretty cool. And the last one, of course, is the grenade egg. We're gonna keep our distance. There we go. And now unveil the golden egg little nest right there, which will give us unlimited eggs, which I always love. And here we go, another mini game. We're in the Fabled Pot of Gold. This is a shooting challenge. Basically, I get at least 75 Jiggies hit in 45 seconds. If we get 90 or more, then we get a Cheeto page. So awesome, an extra prize. And ready, 3, 2, 1. This is my strategy with this one. Focus on a row, go all the way left, circle around once or twice, and then when you're done, go move on to the next. And basically, when you're done with all the columns, just go around and see which ones you missed. So basically, we're just done with the bottom panel right there. We're gonna go across right here. And this strategy is basically the best one I could think of. I've actually never gotten all 100, and I don't know if you get a special prize for doing that, but I pretty much have gotten over 90 consistently. It's pretty easy once you get a little pattern down like this, but hard otherwise if you focus on like one by one, which is pretty stupid, but yeah, I don't know. Anyway, we are almost dwindling down with these things right here. We got 90, so this is just for style points, and let's see how many more we can get. We got 92, okay. So we didn't get 100 like I wanted to, but we got 92, that's a lot. So we get first and second prize at once. Definitely convenient there, we don't have to get one individually, like the Canary Mary race, ugh. And let's see, bet you can't hit all 100, give it a try. I don't know if you actually get a special, I don't think you can. Because there's nothing to collect here, and it's probably just for bragging rights, so I don't think you get anything for hitting all 100, so definitely not worth my time to play a minigame over. And yeah, I think we're pretty much done with what I wanted to do in this world. Okay, one more thing is actually behind the Fabled Pot of Gold is an empty honeycomb piece, and it's actually easier just to send out the clockwork Kazooie, because you don't want to fall off the side potentially, so it's definitely a safer option. But yeah, we're basically done with this part. I did everything I wanted to. We had to unlock a lot of things with Kazooie and Banjo individually, and Mumbo actually did a lot of help right here. So in the next part, Banjo is going to have quite a field day. He's got a lot of Jiggies to get by himself, and I think he's up for the challenge. I think we're up for the challenge of completing the next world in the next part, so yeah, only 3 parts in this world, and I don't think we've done that in a while. Every part's been 4, so yeah, we got 5 Jiggies, and we're pretty much almost done. 38 minutes, awesome. So anyway, thank you guys for watching. In the next part, I'll be finishing out Click Clock Wood, and yeah, hopefully we can do it, and it'll be jam-packed and pretty awesome. So I'll see you later, guys. Until next time, we will finish the last world in the game. See you later.